Does the recycle bin take up space? And where is the recycle bin? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. When you delete a file using the Windows File Explorer, that file is placed into the recycle bin. The recycle bin, I'm sure, has saved many a person from grief, myself included. But where exactly is it? And do the files still take up space if they've been moved to the recycle bin? Let's have a look. So we're here in Windows 11. Everything I'm going through is going to apply to Windows 10 as well, and I believe most of the preceding versions of Windows as well. So first off, I'm firing up Windows File Explorer, and you can see that it's got my default layout. If I take a look at disk C, you'll see that I've got hidden files. Basically, the slightly lighter icons here indicate that these are technically hidden folders. I can see them. And in fact, in the view, show, hidden items is checked. But you know what? That's not enough. What we're going to do is instead use the ellipses, click on options. This should be a familiar dialog box to you. On the view tab, we're going to scroll down and click on this hide protected operating system files. Rather, we're going to uncheck it. And yes, Windows is going to complain. Honestly, I don't know why, but they do treat this differently. So we will say, am I sure I want to do this? Absolutely, I'm here for a reason. I'll click on OK. And you'll notice now that our view of the root of the C drive has changed. There are some other files here. The page file and the swap file are here. But more interestingly, this folder, $recycle.bin, exists. That is the recycle bin on an NTFS formatted hard drive. And indeed, you can take a look inside if you want to. There's stuff. It's not going to be very helpful because it uses its own organization inside of the recycle bin. And we'll talk about how to actually get things out of the recycle bin in a minute. But that's it. That's the recycle bin on an NTFS drive. This other drive I have here, this faux USB, that's an EXFAT drive. On most FAT32, EXFAT, and others, you'll find a hidden folder called Recycle Space Bin. Same idea. In fact, I believe we can look inside of it. There's stuff here. But in fact, you'll notice that when we clicked into it, and this is true when we clicked into it before, that it's actually showing us the entire recycle bin, both recycle bins. You can tell because the original location listed for some of these files is both the C drive and the E drive, the drive that I'm actually looking at. Now you'll notice that this is different than $recycle.bin. Recycle space bin actually includes the files. You can actually see what's in here. And you can see also what their original location was. Interestingly enough, what you've actually opened is the recycle bin icon on your desktop. I'm going to go ahead and open that and you'll see that it looks exactly the same. This is the recycle bin. It has all of these things that have been deleted but not yet removed. Their original location, what drive they were originally on, in this case it's both C and E. I've got files from both. When they were deleted, how big they are, etc. How big they are? Yes, they absolutely continue to take up space on your hard drive until you get them permanently deleted from the recycle bin. Now, there are two ways to do that. In here, we can right-click on it and click on the garbage can icon, or delete if that's what you're seeing. Since we're in the recycle bin, a delete within the recycle bin is a permanent delete. So I'll go ahead and click on that. Do I want to permanently delete this folder? Yes, I do. That folder is now gone and it is no longer taking up space. The other thing you can do, of course, is to right-click on the recycle bin and click on empty recycle bin. And in fact, as we're looking at the recycle bin, you'll see there's a link to empty the recycle bin. You can also restore all items if you want to, but you can also right-click on a specific file, and click on Restore for it to restore things one at a time. But the bottom line here for the space issue is that, well, yeah, when you delete something that gets moved to the recycle bin, it's still on your hard disk. It's still taking up space. It may be on a different hard disk than you think, but it's still taking up space. When you delete something that gets moved to the recycle bin, it does not move it to another hard disk. Rather, it moves it to a recycle bin that is specifically set up for that specific hard disk. Now, there's interesting stuff you can do. It seems like eventually you could just run out of room completely. However, that's not the case. You can control what Windows imposes as an upper limit on how much space a recycle bin will take up. I'm going to right-click on the recycle bin icon on my desktop again, and this time click on Properties. You'll notice that it is listing the two drives we've been playing with. These are the two drives that Windows currently knows have recycle bins. For each of them, you can see that, okay, space available, it's 126 gigabyte drives, both of them. However, that's not all available to the recycle bin. You can set a custom maximum size. This one, in my case, 8549, was chosen by Windows when I set it up. However, if you want to make it something different, you can, say, change it to 1. Apply. And now, basically, anything that causes the recycle bin on drive E, because that's the one I've been playing with, to exceed 1 megabyte in size will cause the oldest files in that recycle bin to be deleted. In other words, that recycle bin will not use more than 1 megabyte. More commonly, maybe 0.5 gigabyte might be a good number to do. I'll go ahead and hit apply on that. You'll notice, though, that that's for drive E. For drive C, well, it's got a bigger number. It's got the default number. And I'll go ahead and change that to a full gigabyte, 1024 megabytes. We'll click on apply. This way, you're controlling how much space the recycle bin can possibly take up. Again, if what you're deleting is about to cause the recycle bin to exceed this limit, then the older files in the recycle bin will be deleted permanently. So, yes, every drive will be listed here, even though it is one set of controls on the recycle bin. You can jump through some hoops to empty the recycle bin on only one drive. Remember, if we right-click on the recycle bin and say empty the recycle bin, it's going to empty the recycle bin on all the drives that have recycle bins. What if I only want to empty the recycle bin on E? Maybe that's where I'm running out of space. As it turns out, I've got a bit of a hack that's pretty easy and safe. Back in Windows File Explorer, I'm going to go over to my drive E, and you can see I've got a recycle bin. I'm going to delete it. Boom, the recycle bin is gone. Remember, the recycle bin can't be placed in the recycle bin. That doesn't make any sense. So deleting the recycle bin permanently deletes the recycle bin and everything in it. However, as soon as you delete something else that would get moved into the recycle bin will be recreated. What that means, though, is simply by deleting the recycle bin folder, and this works for $recycle.bin on NTFS drives as well, simply by deleting that folder, you've effectively emptied that recycle bin on that drive alone. So, ultimately, yeah, the recycle bin is something we really don't think about a whole lot, but as I said earlier, it's saved my bacon more than once. And now, you have a little bit more understanding of exactly where it is, what space it uses, and how it works. For updates, for comments, for links related to this article and more, visit askleo.com/173788. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.